Καλημέρα, good morning. I'll start right away. The excuse of this for this presentation is a growing interest that we start seeing on bowtie methodology and barrier management coming from prominent Greek shipping companies the past 8 months. We observe that bowtie methodologies and barrier-based risk management is slowly finding their way to shipping, mainly due to external recommendation and pressure from charterers. So we start taking a good look into it and to see what can maritime industry can the benefit of and can achieve by using such methodologies. So, how do accidents happen? Accidents happen when barriers fail to prevent causes into developing to undesired effects and consequences. These systems need to be, let's say, addressed and developed into a risk management framework by using models. And bowtie modeling can be a very powerful tool in order to tell a story, how a risk event is developing and is subsequently managed. There is a long history of bowtie methodology coming from the oil and gas sector originally, and it developed there as a very powerful visualization and communication tool. This is the main benefit of bowtie models and methodology. They can transform hundreds of lines of Excel's risk assessment sheets or even large documents in safety management systems into a very clear, very concise A4 or A3 paper picture. And they have a structure and they have a formalism associated with them. So, what is a bow tie diagram? It's a diagram that correlates certain undesired effects, like a top event, that come when we enter into operations. Each operation is involving some hazards, and these hazards can lead to some undesired effects. And with bowtie methodology, we try to describe this path, starting from the threats on the left-hand side, what can go wrong and how we can prevent it in a sequential order. First, how we can eliminate threats from evolving, and then if they do exist, how we can prevent them from resulting to an undesired effect. And then on the other hand, on the other side, on the right hand side, we have the mitigation barriers. Mitigation barriers in the first line of defense that prevent an undesirable effect to lead to the harmful consequences, and the second line of defense, which is to reduce the severity of the consequences if they start to evolve. This picture, as I said, can serve very well into communicating and managing risk, especially in very large and complex processes. Of course, the right level of detail is paramount. You can either go too generic and do a bowtie, let's say, model for shipping, for sea passage, which would be too generic to offer some practical information and advice, or one can go too specific, which is again bad, because then if you have a bow tie for a cylinder liner replacement, then you lose the big picture. So the ideal bow ties is somewhere in the middle, when we have hazards that are big enough, can be understood at all levels of management in for instance, a shipping company, and they can offer real insight on how this can be managed. Is a very well-established methodology, predominantly in the oil and gas, and that's why requests to shipping start to arrive from the oil majors that they applied for decades, and now they start to recommend these approaches to their marine operations and their subcontractors, meaning the shipping companies. Aviation has a long and very successful history of using bow ties, and especially using them as an industry as a whole, having standard bow ties there. Bow ties can find their way in the entire risk management framework, and their main, let's say, goals are to make risks understandable, to serve as communication tools, be used in order to derive best practices. They can facilitate risk-based decision making. They can support audits because they are concise. They convey the information in a fast and robust way. And they can communicate also improvements and support learning of the entire organization and the operators. Especially for shipping, bow ties can be very successful in to visualize main maritime risks, leading to lean safety management systems, which is a question that eventually we'll have to address here. In that way, having a lean and concise picture, they can be used in order to improve communication, both internally in a company, but also with the external stakeholders, charterers, and the regulating authorities. They can provide a much better overview of a situation by identifying what are the threats, the consequences, the barriers in between, correct identification of what is a hazard and what is a top event, leading to improved operations. And of course, they can also be applied into incident investigations. The question is how we apply this methodology into shipping, and the answer can be very broad and very simple. We can successfully apply it if we develop a common understanding and application approach as an industry, as a maritime and shipping cluster. And for this, we need common definitions, because there are many applications of the bow tie models and methodology, but they lack common definition. We need to derive for our industry what is the appropriate definition of a hazard, of a top event. Barrier, for instance. Barriers, experts say that need to be effective, independent, and audible. And we see many times in bow tie models that training, for instance, appears as a barrier. Training is not effective and independent by itself. Instead, in a proper bow tie framework, training would have been a degradation control, a mean in order to keep a barrier in place. And standardization. Developing a common understanding is one thing. A common application approach. And standardization, it's pretty much easy for the shipping industry, because ships, in different ship segments, okay, but still they have major common operations. In barrier, in bow tie terminology, we call them hazards, that can be common for many ship types. Navigation, confined waters navigation again, bunkering, mooring, cargo operation. These are major hazards, important for every ship type and operator, and they can be grouped together, analyzed together, and of course, the bow tie methodology is not stopping into safety. It has already been applied into financial risk, into technical risk, and so on and so forth. So it can provide a very targeted and robust methodology for shipping companies. It requires cooperation, of course, and it requires the shipping industry working together. And in the Greek shipping cluster, we see the first time, the first signs of shipping companies coming together and wanted to develop this further. So that was my presentation on both eyes, and thank you very much for it.